Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. Continuing on our series with the Onyx by Orion devices, I want to show you how you can replace a good chunk of the functionality that you have with either a Google Home or an Amazon Echo, any of those devices. You can actually replace a lot of the home automation capabilities with just this and your phone. So let me show you how to go about that right after this. So this video assumes that you already have your Onyx paired with your iPhone or your Android device, and that you already have an account with Onyx or Orion. Within If This Then That, and this is where everything starts, you can actually search for Onyx or Orion, and you will find the Orion service. Now what you're going to do is connect that service to your account that you've already used to sign up when you were setting up your Onyx device. So you'll need to authorize, and then from there you can see all of these applets that are already here. You can see integration with WeMo, you can see integration with Gmail, Samsung SmartThings, and down at the bottom, just on the base page, we actually have access to Alexa as well. You can see the triggers, so you can choose which group, who says what, and what word or phase, and then you can also choose the action. So again, which group hears it, who specifically in that group hears it, and what does your Onyx say? So basically, you're going to either be able to trigger through certain words, and you're also going to be able to cause certain messages to come out of your Onyx. Now I'm just going to go ahead and create an applet. I'm going to show you how this works. I'm going to search for Orion, and then you can see the one trigger where it says listen for a word or a phrase. So all you're going to do is speak into your Onyx device, and you can choose which group, who says it. If you had multiple people in there, you could see that as well. And then which word or phrase you want Onyx to listen for, and by proxy the If This Then That service. So I chose basement lamp on, and now I'm choosing my Hue light as the action. So I could choose to just toggle the lights, but in this case, because I said that my word was basement lamp on, I'm actually going to say turn on that light, and you can see it in my pick list here, basement lamp. So I create that action. And now what I have is if anyone in the family group says basement lamp on, it will turn on the basement lamp. Now I'm going to show you another one. This is where things can get really deep. So again, we're going to start with the trigger for Orion, and we're going to choose a word or phrase here of trigger workflow. And the reason I'm choosing that is if you've ever heard of Stringify, that service is capable of running very complex workflows, and it has a whole suite of other actions and services that it is integrated with. So you can see I already have a flow in the system called turn off pump. And so if anyone said trigger workflow, you could turn off that pump. Now, obviously that's very useful for business, but even in a home, if you wanted to, you could do something like I had done where you could just trigger turning off a sump pump. Now let me show you something a little bit different. If you're looking to purchase something, and this extends beyond the capability of a Google Home or an Echo, so I can request from eBay if I have the search term Google Home, and I can set a maximum price. So I'm going to set that for $100. Keep in mind that's USD on the If This Then That service. And then I'm going to choose Orion. Now it's going to send a voice message, and I'm just going to choose just to me, and you can see the ingredients that are in here already. I'm going to add in some text just to make it sound right. So I'm going to say a Google Home is available on eBay, named the title, and at a price of, and I'm just going to remove the URL. I don't need that. And I'm going to hit create action. So whenever a new Google Home or a new item related to Google Home comes onto eBay, my Onyx will actually read it out for me, and the If This Then That service will store it within it. So let me show you what that looks. Here's what you get in If This Then That, along with the notification that you get on your phone. So you can go straight to the eBay item, and if you wanted, you could place a bid or buy it. Now here's what it sounds like when you get the notification through Onyx.
Google Home available on eBay, named Google Home Smart Assistant Voice, activated speaker, white slash slate, pre-owned at price $65.
Now, just because the If This Then That service has hundreds of applications or devices that it can connect to, this gives you the opportunity to connect your Onyx and trigger all kinds of functionality through your Onyx, and then have your Onyx repeat back or send you a message based on what's happened in your home. So I think that's good for today. I think it's pretty clear how you could use these devices to actually replace a lot of the functionality around a Google Home or an Echo. Obviously, it's not going to do everything, but you get awfully close when you consider all of the extra functionality you're getting and the capability of communicating with people instantaneously with these Onyx devices. Thanks everyone for watching. We'll see you next time.